going on, guys? It's K-Dub here with another episode of Crypto Zombie. Welcome back to the channel. Hope you're having an awesome day today. Hope you enjoyed the halving yesterday. Having a look right now, kind of boring for Bitcoin, actually. We are seeing some of the altcoins coming out to play. This usually does happen when Bitcoin tends to go sideways for a bit. We have kind of been trending sideways. Bitcoin tried to break above the $9,200 level. We did get rejected, so I do want to talk about that. We have pretty much talked about the halving and that the actual event itself really isn't the major catalyst. It sort of just, you know, ignites the spark. Having a look right here, guys, we do have a 1,458-day wait until the next halving. Aren't you just so excited? But realistically speaking, having a look at all the previous times that Bitcoin's block rewards did get cut in half, we did not see an immediate crazy blast off, right? It actually took Bitcoin a few months, but eventually all of them did lead into major rallies. And as you can see right above my head right now, Bitcoin is essentially due for its next bull market. Now, we need to talk about realistically what we should be expecting. I mean, you could see right here, if we have a look at all of the prices on Bitcoin, this is for May 1st of every year since 2011. I don't have to tell you what's going on with this chart, and you can see clearly the first halving, $5, second halving, $453, third halving, $8,814. So we're going to talk about that, what to realistically expect. Now, some people are freaking out. They're talking about miner capitulation, right? The miners are going to be mining for half the profit. They're going to have to shut down their machines. This could slow down Bitcoin transactions, create some kind of a spiral, right? So we're going to talk about, is this just fudge? Should you be worried about that? I do want to talk about some people actually speculating that the S&P 500 could be looking for a potential major crash soon. And is this going to affect the Bitcoin price? We have seen Bitcoin sort of correlated with the stocks somewhat, right? And finally, I want to end on the fact that we've seen Mike Novogratz. We've seen all of these big institutional players, billionaire Paul Tudor Jones, investing over $100 million into Bitcoin. What do these guys see? Why you should be bullish? And I'm going to go into fundamentals about Bitcoin and why I am still extremely excited for the future, and hopefully you are too. That being said, we need to dive directly into the video, and if you're not subscribed, definitely consider it. Hopping on in over here, we can see, hey, y'all got any more of those $3,600 Bitcoins? I mean, you know, nobody wants to buy when it's cheap, and then everybody rushes in when price gets high. Also today, in honor of the halving, Ledger Nano is running a 50% off discount with the code WEARETHEBULLRUN for Ledger Nano S's, so if you haven't gotten a chance to pick yourself up one, today is a great opportunity. I will leave links below in the description and also in the pinned comment. But having a look right here, we can see that we did have the halving. If we go into the blocks over here, scroll down, boom, there you go. We've now gone from 12.5 to 6.25 Bitcoin. It has been cut in half. And before we get into the charts, I just want to show you, this was really cool. So this was actually included in block number 629,000. And basically, in the Coinbase, they wrote New York Times, April 9th, 2020, with $2.3 trillion injected, the Fed's plans far exceeds the 2008 rescue. And this was a beautiful homage to the Genesis block, which if you guys don't know, they actually included the Times, January 3rd, 2009, Chancellor on brink of second bailout. And it was based on this article over here, and Satoshi put that in the block. So really awesome. Definitely was an exciting day yesterday. Now having a look at Bitcoin. So granted, it was a little bit of a lackluster event. We actually have been supported by the bottom of this uptrend, and we are pushing back up during towards the heart line again. So this actually showed that we did have a nice bounce off the bottom. Bitcoin was bought back up, right? We did have a bounce off of both the 200 and the 100 daily moving averages, and we are still in this uptrend. So it is possible, you know, for Bitcoin to potentially come down to some of these levels again. Like I said, even if Bitcoin was to retest $7,700, I would still be bullish. In fact, having a look over here, even if Bitcoin was to fall all the way down to the VPVR where it starts to drop off, even around the $6,600 level, that would put us right here, and we would still technically be putting in, actually that would be matching it, but you know, as long as we stayed above it, even if we got to, like, let's say the 6,800 right here on the VPVR, that would still be Bitcoin putting in a higher low. So, you know, maybe the price got a little bit away from itself. Maybe people got a little bit too excited, but ultimately we still are trending upwards. You can see right here, we actually have a lot of support in the VPVR right around the $7,200 level. This is like a really popular level for Bitcoin. Lots of accumulation happens around the $7,200 level. Not quite sure why, but I do anticipate Bitcoin to hopefully be supported at around that level. We are putting in a nice green monthly candle above the 50-week moving average. And like I did say right here, we had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 candles on the weekly. And what's interesting, Galaxy BTC actually pointed out, look what happened the last time we had 7 consecutive green weekly candles. We had a doji candle, some people may actually call it a bit of a spinning top, but you know, just for example, followed by a 160% increase. He says, by the looks of it, we are in for quite a ride. And in yesterday's video, I showed you guys that Bitcoin is putting in a descending broadening wedge. And whether or not this pattern comes out, you can see right here, whether it comes out of the formation after a trough or a formation after the peak, it has an 80% and a 79% chance. So let's just basically say 80% chance of breaking to the upside. And as I showed you guys yesterday, if we take that right here and we move it over to where we're at right now, assuming we do have the breakout, we don't fall down to retest the lows, that puts Bitcoin at around $15,500. So the question is, do you guys have the ability to HODL, okay? And also, not to mention the fact that we do have this extremely large, actually, it's the biggest CME futures gap that Bitcoin has ever seen. And that is right up here at around $9,820. So from the price that Bitcoin is at right now, moving up to that level, that would actually be over a 10% increase from where we're at right now. So let me know if you guys are excited about that. But let's talk about the halving. Let's talk about historically and what's going on right now. So if we look basically from now, let's just go from now until the end of the year. That is roughly, let's just say it's about, let's say it's about 235 days, just give or take, depending on the time you're watching. Well, I've actually mapped that out previously right here. And if we were to go roughly about 235 days from the halving, you know, forward, you see right here, the halving started out very boring back here in 2013, not really much happened. And then finally, it had a major blast off. It got all the way up about 2,554%. And you could see if we go at the same time to the end of the year, that was about a 750% increase, the last halving, okay, at around the same amount of time. Bitcoin, in about 235 days, we had about a 91% increase. So this one wasn't as big. So the question is, you know, even if Bitcoin was to have, let's just say, not even that much, let's say we have like a 50% increase from that to the end of the year. We're not even going to go that crazy. We don't have to go to 90, okay? That still takes us to about $12,000, $13,000. And I did show you that if we were to break out of this descending broadening wedge, that would bring us to about $15,500. So are you patient enough to wait to the end of the year? And honestly, if it goes lower, I consider it a great opportunity to just continue to accumulate more Bitcoin. Now, Peter Schiff actually was talking about, oh, all the Bitcoin pumpers are front running the Paul Tudor Jones Squawk Box CNBC interview. And somebody actually said, hey, when are you going to actually admit that you screwed up and you should have bought Bitcoin? Well, Peter Schiff actually admitted that he was wrong. He says he should have bought Bitcoin when he first learned about it, as he could have made a lot of money selling into the hype. He says, but my original assessment of its ultimate value is still correct. So it would be an even bigger mistake to buy Bitcoin now. But that's not what a lot of investors are saying. Mike Novogratz actually came over here on CNBC to sort of talk about it. And he actually mentioned Paul Tudor Jones allocating over $100 million worth of his net worth into Bitcoin, and why he actually thinks that this is a good thing. And it does sort of create that validity, or sort of open the door for others to jump in as well, right? You're always skeptical to be the first investor. So I'm going to play this video super quick, and then we're going to talk about it.
Bitcoin falling today following the halving. And for those of you who don't know what it is, it's a technical event that reduces the number of Bitcoins rewarded to miners, in turn reducing the number of Bitcoins mined. Mike Novogratz is still with us. So what's your take on the event? It certainly seemed a little bit like a sell the news kind of event, at least initially.
Yeah, a little bit. I think there was a lot of hype going into the halving, right? We've come off from 4,500, so huge rally, a lot of retail participation. There's a great macro backdrop. We've talked about it ad infinitum of why crypto right now, and Bitcoin specifically, makes so much sense. And then you had the news that Paul Jones had bought it and then bought it for his fund, which is, I think, really, really significant. And so you had a little bit of a retail frenzy. That got sold off. I would expect the market to hold here at 8,000, 8,500 and to start trading right back up. We're seeing at our shop just a huge increase in interest in Bitcoin and getting into crypto from high net worth individuals, from funds. You know, crypto is not easy to buy. It takes a while to get set to buy it. If it was easy to buy, it would be much higher. And so it doesn't happen overnight, but it feels like a herd is on its way, finally. You know, I coined that phrase a long time ago, and I'd been waiting and waiting from the institutional side. And I think this Tudor news is very big news because in some ways it takes the career risk of looking dumb out of buying Bitcoin. It credentializes it as a macro weapon. You know, it might or might not work, but people aren't going to say, oh, you were a fool to do that. You know, that's Tulos. No, it's now seen as a legitimate store of value. And I think it'll allow other hedge funds to participate as well.
Yeah, you don't want to be the first guy, that's for sure. BK, you got a question for Novo?
So I'm curious, we've seen in the past with these halvings, you see a sell-off 30 to 60 days. Are you positioned that way where we have a sell-off for 30 days and then the real rally comes? Or do you think that's the last two times and we're not going to have it again?
No, I laughed. I had a really original strategy of kind of selling into the halving and then buying the pullback. But we have seen so much activity that I didn't sell a damn thing. I put a HODL sign, you know, hold on for dear life sign, which is a crypto term where, you know, the real core crypto guys never sell. I really think that the movement we're seeing, listen, the happening comes almost at a perfect time. If you think about this macro backdrop of quantitative easing on top of quantitative easing, the happening is quantitative tightening. And so, it's like an exclamation point on the macro story of why a scarce asset like Bitcoin should go higher. And so I haven't sold. I think, you know, I missed the sell-off, and I think you're going to see the thing base here. And we will take out 10,000, you know, we will go to 20,000 by the end of the year. I feel real confident about it.
Wow, so $10,000, and he's completely confident that we're going to hit $20,000 by the end of this year. But the thing that you really have to look at is how early everybody really is. Some people say, oh, I'm not early to Bitcoin because I didn't buy it at $1 or $400 or $1,000 or whatever. But when you have a look at how small the market cap of Bitcoin, that orange little dot over there, is compared to all of the money in the world, you then begin to realize that this thing is simply just getting started. But I already hear somebody yelling out there, but K-Dub, what about the fact that Bitcoin is correlated to stocks? Well, we've actually proven that it's not 100% correlated, but it does kind of rhyme it a little bit. So having a look over here, I do want to talk about what happened over at Bloomberg. They did have some technical strategists from JP Morgan that basically said that you need to be careful because it looks like the S&P 500 could potentially be forming a price ceiling at around $2,940. In fact, Cold-Blooded Shiller over on Twitter, if you follow him, also has an indicator that says he might be looking for a bit of a top right now. You can see this blue line looks like it's about to curve over into the pink, just like it did right at the peak before the major crash. So essentially what they say is that the S&P 500 index staged a bearish reversal week after moving deeper into the large confluence of resistance levels surrounding the $2,900 point level. While the two-day pullback from that key resistance area is only tentative at this point, it at least marks a continuation of the trend declaration pattern that started in mid-April. And I highlighted this down here, but essentially Goldman Sachs also agrees with them as well. And on top of that, we have Charles Edwards and many others out there saying this will be the most brutal Bitcoin halving in history. Production cost is about to double to $14,000, 70% above the current price. Last halving price was just 10% below production cost, and price and HR collapsed negative 20% without FOMO. Now expect a huge minor capitulation. So what does this mean? Is this doom and gloom? Is Bitcoin gonna basically get slowed down, bogged down? Are transactions gonna take hours to happen? What's gonna happen to price? Well, that is the beauty of the Bitcoin blockchain. You can see right here, we have a difficulty adjustment in 5 days and 20 hours. So yes, things could get a little bit choppy in the next week. We could see some sort of craziness happen on the network. But at the end of the day, the network is designed to adjust to these things, okay? When the difficulty gets too complicated and miners are dropping out, turning off their machines, it will adjust to make it profitable for the miners that are able to stay in the game. So this is why I'm not worried. I'm never worried when I hear about things like miner capitulation. I mean, does it suck for some of these miners? Yeah, totally. Some of these guys might even go out of business. But for the actual network itself, for the users, I'm not worried at all. So that's basically my take on that moving forward. And also, guys, there was a 47,837 Bitcoin transaction. That's how many Bitcoins were sent in a transaction. And to just kind of give you an idea of how much that is, 47,837. Let's do that right now with the current price. So 47,837. Yeah, so that was $425 million sent in under 10 minutes. Oh, and it was for a fee of about $1.78. So you're definitely not going to send gold across the world for that cheap, right? That being said, guys, no, you can't just cut the block reward in half. Well, actually, you can, and that is the code right here behind me, which is pretty incredible. Built in, don't trust, verify. And on that note, I did want to end today's video with something positive, and this is a thread from Raphael Schultz Kraft, and you can see right here, Bitcoin fundamentals are stronger than ever. Very long thread, we're not going to go into it, but essentially, you could see the network is growing. The hash rate is growing, okay, right here. The number of Bitcoin addresses are up. The number of whales are up. Addresses holding one Bitcoin or more are up. Both the number of Bitcoin addresses and entities holding 1,000 Bitcoin are up. Network activity is also up. The Bitcoin volume is also up as well. Guys, things are growing. Things are looking good for Bitcoin moving forward. And yeah, on that note, did you guys see that they literally censored, or at least YouTube removed, the Coin Telegraph live stream, unfortunately. So looks like YouTube is still out there. Now, I do understand there are a lot of scam YouTube giveaways still out there. Be careful. Any of these live streams claiming to be doing Bitcoin giveaways, they're total scams. Unfortunately, what's happening right now is it looks like YouTube is a bit understaffed and they have to basically manually review all of these. So unfortunately, a lot of these videos, including some of my videos and many other videos of content creators, crypto and non-crypto related, have been taken down. So was unfortunate that that happened, but hopefully we'll eventually get over this. But yeah, I will be looking to upload on more decentralized platforms as well. I do also have my backup account. If you guys want, you know, you can go over here. Basically, you just scroll over here to Crypto Zombie Undead. Just click that. It's on my channel, and that's my backup channel in case you guys want to get subscribed. You know, just in case one of my videos in the future does get shadow banned. You know, like the video where I said that Bitcoin price was probably gonna dump, and then 8 hours later it actually dumped, and you know, YouTube decided to remove that. So some people were unable to see those videos, but that's it for me today, guys. Thank you so much for coming back to the channel. You guys rock. You're the reason that I do this every single day. Hope you enjoy your day. Hope you enjoyed the halving. Hope you're ready to hodl on for dear life all the way to a potential $20,000 Bitcoin, according to Mike Novogratz. And like I said, according to our descending broadening wedge, which I don't remember where I put it. Where did I put it? I don't know, somewhere in here I had it. Yeah, we are looking for a major pump. I don't know why I can't find where. Oh, here it is right here. Yeah. So like I said, $15,500 Bitcoin potentially, but you let me know. Maybe we're just going to crash. You know, like I said, guys, there is that possibility of coming back down here, touching some of these lower levels before having the massive blast off. But I've been rambling on for way too long. That's it for me. My name is K-Dub. This is Crypto Zombie. Until next time, stay crypto. And of course, peace out.